Laika the dog. Does this name ring any bells? Whether you regularly visit art museums, watch a lot of movies, listen to a lot of folk music, or you're an avid book reader, you must have heard or read about Laika the dog, or one of her many avatars. But do you know what really happened to the 3-year-old Siberian husky, and how she became a popular inspiration for artists all over the world? Continue watching this video as we tell you all about an innocent dog's involuntary suicide mission into space. But before we begin though, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on space. The story dates back to 1957, when Russia regularly and unapologetically used animals for scientific and medical experiments. A dog named Kudryavka, fondly known as Laika, was sent to space on a one-way ticket. They called her a dog cosmonaut, and her purpose was to prove whether life outside of Earth was possible or not. So, in November 1957, Soviet engineers planned an impetuous space mission at the request of Premier Nikita Khrushchev, who wanted the launch to coincide with the 40th anniversary of the Russian Bolshevik Revolution. The launch was not an isolated incident. The planning and execution, however hasty, took time and effort. The first step was to plan and build a spaceship. Using their learnings from an earlier unmanned mission called Sputnik, Soviet engineers began their work on a ship that was now supposed to include a small pressurized space for a dog. The mission was called Sputnik 2 and was preceded by a search for the perfect dog to orbit space. For the Russian animal recruiters, the perfect dog for the job was one that was docile, small in size, obedient, and adaptive to changes to and around them. While Laika was the one who was put to the ultimate test, the other dog candidates too were put through quite a lot of misery. Rescued from the streets of Moscow, they were all tested physically and mentally for weeks on end. Once the recruiters chose obedient and passive dogs, put them in small pressurized spaces for weeks at a stretch, and observed them for their reactions to changing air pressure and loud noises. Lastly, the dogs were fitted with a sanitation device to check their reaction to it. Most dogs hated it so much, they refused to even defecate to avoid activating the device. However, some dog candidates adapted to all the changes well, as the quest for the chosen one continued. A couple of weeks later, after all the tests had been conducted, it was time to introduce the next Russian cosmonaut to the world. This is when Kudryavka, later named Laika, was introduced to the world through the radio. For publicity reasons, the chosen dog had to be good-looking, and was also given a new name so that people could grow fond of the dog. Thus began Laika's journey as the first living creature to ever orbit the Earth. To prepare and train her further, scientists placed monitoring devices in her body that would record her body temperature, heartbeat, blood pressure, and movement. She was then acclimatized into her travel compartment 3 days before the mission was scheduled to launch. On November the 3rd at around 5:30 a.m, Laika was all set to take off, with her hand devices intact and a spacesuit with built-in metal restraints. The spacecraft had an oxygen generator installed, and also had instruments to absorb carbon dioxide and avoid oxygen poisoning. The spacecraft was also equipped with a fan to balance the temperature, keep the dog cool, and keep the food edible. Oleg Gazenko, one of the lead Soviet scientists on the project, had developed a soft spot for Laika while she was in training. Despite knowing about her inevitable demise, his fondness towards her was so strong that he insisted on getting a window built in the pressurized capsule to have a view while in her isolation. However, the cabin was too small, and there was no space at all for the dog to even turn around in the cabin. It was reported that the confined space caused Laika to stop urinating or defecating, and the little space also made her feel restless and anxious during her journey. Anxious and terrified of the new environment, Laika rode the rocket into the Earth orbit, 2,000 miles from Moscow. The loud noises in the confined space were starting to take their toll on Laika as her heart rate quadrupled in anxiety and fear. Recorded proofs of which exist even today. However heroic it might seem, the journey was a doomed journey right from the start. While the engineers knew how to send the rocket into space, there was no technology whatsoever to get it back into Earth. Adil Vakodvieska, one of the main engineers on the mission, said in an interview, "Of course, we knew she was destined to die on the flight, since there was no way to get her back. This wasn't possible at the time." The engineers, however, thought that Laika would suffer a painless death due to oxygen deprivation after 15 days of the launch. Unfortunately though, the ill-fated dog succumbed to the harsh conditions barely minutes after the spaceship entered space. The environment in the spacecraft was in itself in no way conducive for a canine to survive. And to top it all off, the heat shield got damaged soon after the launch. This led to the sudden rise in the spacecraft's temperature right after the ninth orbit. For several days, the Soviet government let its citizens believe that Laika was alive, but in reality, she had died almost immediately after the loss of the heat shield. Laika was not the first dog to have been used for scientific research, and she definitely wasn't the last. But her death came at a time when animal rights activists were just beginning to form unions in Europe and America. Russian space programs, as well as other scientific researchers, have used dogs for experiments over and over again. In Laika's case, the Soviet Union had no technology to get the spacecraft safely back to Earth. And so, her death was considered a deliberate decision by the authorities. The international community reacted as groups like the Royal Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals and the British Society for Happy Dogs had started protesting the launch in Great Britain as well as in New York. In the UK, the Royal Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals planned protests outside the Soviet embassy in London, and the British Society for Happy Dogs called for a minute of silence for Laika. In New York, dog lovers protested in front of the UN building with signs like criticizing the decision to send Laika into space. Laika's death not only inspired movements for the championing of animal rights, but it also left a huge cultural impact in the world. And her story lives on even today in the form of different artworks. Many films, documentaries, folk songs, paintings, and even books are either fully dedicated to her sacrifice or mention her in some way or the other. In 2015, Russia unveiled a commemorative statue of Laika on the top of a rocket at one of Moscow's military research facilities. A 1985 film, My Life as a Dog, prominently mentions Laika as one of the main characters, as a young Swedish boy comes to identify strongly with the dog. Laika was also the inspiration for a 2007 graphic novel by the author Nick Abadis. The book even earned the author the Eisner Award for Best Publication for Teens. Not just this, Laika is also mentioned in a 2004 song, Neighborhood No. 2, Laika, by Arcade Fire, featuring in a debut album called Funeral. Even in the Czech Republic, Laika became the inspiration for a 2017 animated science fiction comedy film, Laika. These are only some of Laika's many artworks, and her painful journey inspired. You can find references to the dog in a large number of books, songs, music, and other art forms even today. Do tell us your opinion on the decision of sending Laika into the space in the comments section below. And if you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video that is shown in the end screen. See you there.